Right here we have the gallery with the contacts, and now we want to filter the gallery based on what the user types here in this text input. So we want to filter by name. Okay, as I mentioned in the previous class, it's not just putting the input here that it will filter the gallery, but we need to provide the correct formulas. Here in the gallery, with the gallery selected, we can see that we have the TB contact table associated in the items property of the gallery. It means it's showing all the items from that list of data. But if we want to filter it or search, we need to modify this formula to put the function that will do this job to us. So in this case, we have this table, and the column we want to search is called name. As I just said, we want to search in the column name. What do we want to search? We want to search the text that's written here inside the txt name control. Basically, we need to translate this phrase to a Power Apps function that will do the same. So if I go to the gallery, that's where we put the formula, we are going to type the formula that will do the search. In this case, so as I mentioned, we want to search. We have a function called search. Okay, so we want to search in the TB contact. That's the first argument of the function. What do we want to search? From which text do we want to search? We want to search from the txt name. So I will put a comma. And the second argument is the search text. So it means what's the text I'm going to be searching in my database, in my data source. In this case, I want to get the text from that text input. As we just saw, is a text input right here. So the name of that is called txt name. And I want to get the text that the user types inside it. So I will put dot text. Right? So this will give us the text that the user typed inside the text input control. Okay, now if I put a comma, we are going to see the third argument of the function that's called column. It means what's the column I'm going to be searching. In this case, the column is called name. So I can select here the name column, or I can even type between double quotes. Since it's showing here as a suggestion, I will click on it to show here in the formula. Now I have a complete formula. I can close the parentheses. So we are telling to the gallery that the results the gallery is going to show is the search in the TB contacts with the text being the text that the user types inside the txt name control, and we are going to search in the name column. If I play the app, and if I start typing something, so for example, let's say Rudy, it will go to the data source and search in the name column as we just put in the formula here in the gallery. So for example, let's see another name, let's say Bruce. So as I just typed Brew, B-R-U, it will bring everything that has BRU in the name. In this case, we have two Bruces, two words with these letters. So that's why we see two records here. If I just put one letter, let's say R, it will bring everything that has R in the name. All of them, actually. So let's try a different one. Let's say D. So everything that has D in the name will show here. We can also search by more than one column. If I go back to the formula and put an extra comma after the name, column name. So let's say I put a comma, I can add a second column, and then I can put a comma, add a third column, and so on. So let's search by name and by email in this case. So I just put comma email and close the parentheses. Now, if I type something that's in the email, it will also show. So for example, let's say Rudimar at, it will bring the search because my email has the Rudimar at in the text. Now there is a very important point for you to know that this search function is not a delegable function. There is a concept in Power Apps called delegation. It's a little more advanced for who is beginning. So we may not cover now, but maybe in the future if the course progresses with more difficult lessons. But it means that, for example, in this case, I have a parameter here in Power Apps that sets a limit of row, so data row limit. In this case, it means that if my Excel file has more than 500 rows and I use the search function, that's a non-delegable function, it means it's a function that will not apply the filter in the source. It will bring all the records to the app and then filter here inside the app. And in this case, we have a limit of 500. And since this function is not delegable, this will happen. We will have 500 registers brought to the app, and then we are going to do the search inside the app. It means that if we have, let's say, 501 or 700 or 1000 records in the Excel table, and we search a name that's in those lines after 500, we are not going to see the record here in this app. We may think that the app has a problem that's not reading the lines from the Excel. And that's actually true. Excel is not a very good data source for the apps. I recommend just to learn. There are other better data sources. One that's included in the Power Apps, the Office license, is SharePoint. SharePoint is not a database, but a lot of people use to build more complex apps. And then we have databases such as SQL Server, Dataverse, and so on. So we are using Excel here to learn, and also the search function. If you are building an app that has more than 500 rows, you may consider using another approach, and the search may not be very useful. So keep in mind this if you're going to build an app that has a lot of records. Okay, knowing that, there is one extra configuration that I want to show. It's important. If I select the text inputs, we have one configuration here that's called delay output. Right now it's set to false. So it means every time I type any letter here, it will already search in the Excel file and bring the results immediately. So if I keep typing, so for example, R, then U, then D, it will do one search, two searches, three searches, and so on. And that, in an app that's used by a lot of people, will use a lot of throughput, a lot of internet connection. Would be better if the app waited for me to finish typing and then did the search in the Excel file, in the database, in the data source, whatever we are using for the app. So this delayed output will wait for me to finish typing, then to reflect the change in the input. In this case, I need to change to true, and this will cause the app to do less calls to the data source that we are using, and it will be more efficient. So I'll just set to true. Know that this is a performance optimization and you can apply to your apps. Now, in the next video, we want to learn how to search using a dropdown. So we are going to create a table to store the list of departments. And after that, we'll be able to filter by department and later combine the department and the search to be able to filter by both. So see you in the next classes.